There's traffic in the sky and it doesn't seem to be getting much better. There's kids playing games on the pavement, drawing waves on the pavement, mm-hmm. Shadows of the planes on the pavement, mm-hmm. It's enough to make me cry, but that don't seem like it will make it feel better. Well, maybe it's a dream, and if I scream it will burst at the seams. Whole place would fall into pieces, and then they'd say, well, how could we have known? I'll tell them it's not so hard to tell. Nah, nah, nah. You keep adding stone, soon the water will be lost in the well. Mm-hmm. Puzzle pieces in the ground, no one ever seems to be digging. Instead, they're looking up towards the heavens with their eyes on the heavens. Mm-hmm. The shadows on the way to the heavens, mm-hmm. It's enough to make me cry. That don't seem like it will make it feel better. The answers could be found, we could learn from digging down. But no one ever seems to be digging. Instead they'll say, well, how could we have known? I'll tell them it's not so hard to tell. Nah, nah, nah. You keep adding stone, soon the water will be lost in the well. Mm. Words of wisdom all around, but no one ever seems to.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the marriage ceremony of Daryl and Kayla. Am I doing okay so far?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
I hear splashes back there. I'm not sure what's going on. Before we go on with beginning the ceremony, we have a question. Who gives this woman in marriage? Raise your hand.
Father.
That's good. We got the answer.
Father and mother.
Father and mother. Thank you. Daryl and Kayla welcome you. It is their desire that you enter into the joy and beauty and reverence of the following moments. Let us worship God. This is the charge. Dearly beloved, we are assembled here in the presence of God to join this man and this woman in holy marriage, which is instituted of God, regulated by his commandments, and blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and to be held in honor among all men. Let us therefore reverently remember that God has established and sanctified marriage for the welfare and happiness of mankind. Our Savior has declared that a man shall forsake his father and mother and cleave unto his wife. By his apostles, he has instructed those who enter into this relation to cherish a mutual esteem and love, to bear with each other's infirmities and weaknesses, to comfort each other in sickness, trouble, and sorrow, in honor and in industry, to provide for each other and for the household in temporal things, to pray and encourage each other in the things that pertain to God, and to live together as heirs of the grace of life. At this time, we will have the exchange of vows. I have to say it louder.
Yeah.
You look gorgeous.
Thank you.
Good. Okay. Going to be with Daryl. Hi, Daryl.
Hi, buddy.
Can you say it louder?
No. Hi, Daryl.
Hi, Daryl.
Take thee.
Take thee. Kayla.
To be my wedded wife. Oh, it's me, but he kisses.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Sorry, it's fine. To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
According to God's holy plan.
According to God's holy plan.
I give you my love.
I give you my love.
I, Kayla.
I, Kayla.
Take thee, Darren.
Take thee, Daryl.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
To pledge, promise, and commit.
To pledge, promise, and commit.
And to share.
And to share.
All that life has to offer.
All that life has to offer.
According to God's holy plan.
According to God's holy
plan. I give you my love.
I give you my love.
Okay, we will now have the exchange of rings. What token do you give your love, sir?
This ring.
Beautiful. Okay. You take the ring, put it on the finger. And repeat it to me.
Good.
Same thing. With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
Okay, that's all. And now we have to switch papers here.
Okay.
Same thing. Very good. I like your help there.
Like all the notes and highlight.
With this ring.
Wait.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
That's all. It's fine. Bless, O Lord, these rings to be a symbol of the solemn vows by which this man and this woman have bound themselves to each other in holy matrimony through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Now we will celebrate this union as it is symbolized through the pouring of two individual containers of sand. One represents Kayla and all that you are. The other represents Daryl and all that you are. As the two vials of sand are poured into the third keepsake vase, the individual containers of sand ceased to exist as they are newly joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into the individual vases, so will the love and bond between the two of you render you inseparable.
I got that. Sorry. Did you go first? We're gonna spill it. Oh. She said it's okay.
It's wet.
Yeah, but there's a bunch of it. No, oh. It's okay. Let me do something.
This wasn't good. That's pretty.
I told her we were going to miss it. I said, we're not going to be able to get this in that little hole.
Oh. Guys, it's beautiful. Messy, just like a good relationship, right?
Now that you, Daryl, and Kayla have pronounced the promise to give yourselves to one another and to love each other through your sacred vows and through the giving and receiving of these rings, I now pronounce you husband and wife married. And as I said before, those whom God has joined together, may He generously bless forever, and you may kiss one another. You've been waiting for that for years, I know. Because you can rest in the comfort of knowing that you are chosen through one another to serve the highest purposes of love, depart in peace, recognizing that what you undertake together will bring you inestimable joy, and that the love you share can truly help to change the world. Now go forth from this place with jubilation in your hearts and gladness in your feet. And may the Lord of peace himself continually grant you peace in every circumstance. And may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Take the bride home. No, I'm just kidding. who's laughing? Would you please face the people? My dear family, friends, and guests, it is my pleasure to present for the very first time Mr. and Mrs. Daryl Dixon.
Someday you wish high above the chimney top, that's where you find me. Oh, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, and the dream that you did to, oh why can't I? Well, I see trees of green and red roses too. I watch them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Well, I see skies of blue and I see clouds of white and the brightness of day. I like the dark and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people passing by.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to go ahead and welcome in the parents of the bride and groom, so make some noise as we welcome in the parents of the bride, Todd O'Keefe and Cindy Alsop. Well, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise as we welcome in the parents of the groom. We have Don and Jerry Dixon. Noise as we welcome our bridal party to the reception. First, welcome in flower girl Josie. She's with junior bridesmaid Avery. They're escorted by groomsman Danny. Keep those hands clapping, ladies and gentlemen, as we welcome in junior bridesmaid Hannah. She's with groomsman Terrell. Hands clapping as now we welcome in bridesmaid Christy. She's with groomsman Philip. Well, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise as we welcome in bridesmaid Lisa. She's escorted by groomsman Ty. Put your hands together as I introduce our maid of honor. She's escorted by one of our groomsmen. We have Stephanie Ann Lance. And make some noise as we welcome in our matron of honor. She's escorted by one of our groomsmen. We have Kelly and Todd Dixon. This time, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to invite all guests to please rise. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Make some noise. This is the moment you've been waiting for, as it is my honor and pleasure to introduce you for the second time today, the brand new Mr. and Mrs. Daryl Dixon.
Let's move it up. I got my money. Let's move it up. Welcome to our celebration. I'm Tom O'Keefe, father of the bride. Kayla asked me to offer the invocation before the meal. But first, I have to roast the groom. Oh, no, that was yesterday, sir. I'm going to talk a little bit about my baby. Kayla was the second kid out on her birthday at 91, just minutes after her sister Kelly. Kayla wasn't even reluctant to exit her first home because she liked adventuring new things. She was going to get a big dose of both. After her first breath and her eloquent cry, we knew we had a college communication major coming at us. You know, you get married and you have kids and they grow up in a speedy blur as you watch them learn and develop in absolute amazement. We were blessed to have four kids, and each one was unique and fascinating. Kayla was the optimistic, funny, lovable little kid who was always happy. She was fun to play with, fun to play tricks on, and to tease relentlessly. Not me, her brother Jake. Oh, all right, me too. And Kayla was, and is, the family glue and the family heart. Kayla had a stellar high school career. She was in the National Honor Society, chorus, drama, cross country, all county and all state chorus, basketball, track, just to name a few. Interestingly, while running several track events, she also threw shot put and discus. Back home, we have the annual end of the summer Lewiston Peach Festival. Part of that involves beauty pageants for children and young ladies. We entered her sister Steph and later Kelly and Kayla in the Peach Blossom competition when they were about 5 years old. None of our children won because the judges were woefully deficient recognizing supreme child cuteness, and our kids weren't relatives of town officials. But Kayla entered the Peach Queen competition when she was 17 and was voted Miss Congeniality by her fellow contestants. A great honor and classic Kayla. Kayla decided to attend St. Bonaventure University in Western New York. Urbana students. To study journalism communication. It's about a 2-hour drive from home. Our other kids stayed local for college, so I was really concerned for her to be that far away. I was afraid that the student stress, curriculum, and the new and wild college life would contaminate and swallow up that naive, attractive young woman who could only see rainbows, unicorns, and flowers in everyone. And zebras, I suppose. Of course, the opposite happened. She swallowed everyone else up with her happiness and exuberance. In the process, she consistently made the dean's list, sang in chorus, and played college rugby, where she co-captained her team, taking the national championship her junior year. Fellow rugby players, a few years after that, Kayla was living and working in Rochester, New York, and at one point, some guy she met in Florida kept texting her, sending her flowers at work. I had to find this out from her sisters because the communications major didn't want to tell her own father. But then she knew how I felt about tort lawyers. Time then vaporized to the point when one day I got a phone call from a guy in Fiji asking for permission to marry my daughter. And can I please hurry up with my answer because it's a surprise and Kayla was about to enter the room where he was talking with me. Like I had any choice at that point. Is that guy a lawyer or what? So to Kayla and Daryl, may God richly bless you and may you both love each other all the days of your lives together with passion and joy. Please pray with me. Father God, creator of the universe, we praise you and give you glory and thanks for all that you are and all of you have done for us. We have gathered here to witness and celebrate the love and commitment uniting Kayla and Daryl. So, Father, please bless this food we are about to receive as a sign of your continuous bounty and providence. Please send your generous blessings upon Kayla, Daryl, and their families and friends, especially those present here. We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. Thank you.
She feels about something, don't push her to tell you. When she's ready, she will. And most importantly, every day, tell her she's beautiful. I don't care if she just woke up and her hair is in a mess. Tell her anyways. When she's getting dressed for a night out, seems unsure about her outfit, tell her she's beautiful. Kayla and Daryl, being married is such a wonderful experience. To be honest, nothing feels like it changes, but that's not a bad thing. Kayla, start practicing your signature now, because Lord knows you can't turn okay into a DI very easily. Kayla, you'll be staring at your ring for a good month with such a huge smile on your face, and will always think about this day. Daryl, never forget to wear your ring. And if you do, don't tell her. It is so also so awesome when you go out and Daryl introduces you as his wife, and you introduce her as, you get such a warm, fuzzy feeling that you guys are together forever. Kayla, I've been saying it for many years that I am so proud to call you my twin sister. And today I'm so proud to call Daryl my new brother. God bless this marriage, and God bless Daryl and Kayla. I can't drink, I don't have a glass to toast with,
water.
But... Oh! Oh, I can't toast with water, it's bad luck. But to the new Dixons! Oh my gosh.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for Kelly, our matron of honor and sister of the bride. Thank you so much. And ladies and gentlemen, let's have a big round of applause as I introduce our maid of honor, Stephanie, for her toast this evening.
I'd like to thank everyone for coming down to this beautiful place to celebrate with Kayla and Daryl on their special day. As you might know, Kayla's my baby sis. And one of the first things I can remember about you is how small and immobile you were. All I wanted to do was play with you, but seeing that you could only sleep, drool, and stare at me, I knew I figured I would have to wait to play with you until you were a little more fun and entertaining. But little did I know what I was in for. You turned out to be just that person. Fun and entertaining and so much more. You were worth waiting for. You were so energetic, almost to the point of crazy. She was a girly girl, but didn't mind getting her hands dirty here and there. She was this little blonde cutie in a dress, going back to play in the woods, coming up to us with a snail, a frog, or even a snake. She was fearless. She was always entertaining Kelly and I, making us laugh with flashlight shadows when we should be sleeping, playing house where for some reason she always wanted to be the dog, playing with Dad's shaving cream, which was supposed to be played with on the dining room table, but Kayla had it wherever skin was exposed and in her hair. Having Kayla in your life, there's never a dull moment. She's the one that brightens the room when she walks in. I know whenever I see that beautiful smile or hear that infectious laugh, I get goosebumps. Just because being around her makes you a happier person. So mornings I would call her into my bedroom just to get me out of bed. I knew if I started my day with Kayla, it was going to be an unforgettable day. And though she's not one to take compliments well, she sure does give them out to anyone that will take them. She has a huge heart, and if anyone can get you to smile, it's her. And I didn't even get to how beautiful she is yet. I mean, look at her! She's freaking gorgeous! That's what I love so much about her. Kayla is the whole package. She's so smart, kind, independent, creative, loving, so funny, quirky, and not afraid to laugh at herself. She is such a positive person, excels at anything she puts her mind to, and lives life to the fullest. She has made some amazing things in her 26 years. She was the lead in her high school musical. She runs for fun. Went to Ireland, which I'm still jealous about. Played rugby in college. And she was good at it. But if I told you all the things she has done, there'd be no time for dancing or cake. But Kayla, I want you to know how proud I am of you, how proud I am to call you my sister. And on top of all her other achievements today, she adds another one by marrying the luckiest guy in the world. Daryl, you have taken her away from me, but I love nothing more than to see my baby sis happy, and she has found that happiness with you. As you probably know, Kayla and Daryl met down here while my mom, Kelly, Kayla, and I were on our last leg of our vacation. Even though I didn't get to meet Daryl until a few months later, I knew that something was special about him. since the whole ride to the airport the next day was filled with buzzing and beeping coming from Kayla's phone, almost to the point of annoyance. I asked her if she was talking to that guy she met, and she just says no, trying to hide a smile. But every time that phone went off, I watched her face light up or heard that laugh I so much love to hear. I could tell it was going to be the start of something magical. I was right. Kayla and Daryl are living proof that love at first sight is real. People don't usually find their soulmate on vacation, but these two did. It's a rare and beautiful thing, just like my sister, who deserves more than the world. So Daryl, I'm sure you already know this, but just let me remind you to tell her how much you love her every day and how beautiful she is. No matter how busy you are, to steal a kiss or two. I can't do it every day anymore, so I pass that responsibility on to you. I love you both very much, and I'm so excited for your future together. I wish you nothing but love, joy, and complete and utter bliss. Congratulations to my baby sister and my new brother-in-law. To Mr. and Mrs. Dixon, may the love you have for each other be stronger than anything that life throws your way. To Kayla and Daryl.
She spins and she sways to whatever song plays without a care in the world. And I'm sitting here wearing the weight of the world on my shoulders. It's been a long day and there's still work to do. She's pulling at me saying that I need you. There's a ball at the castle that I've been invited, and I need to practice my dancing. Oh please, daddy please. So I dance with Cinderella while she's here in my arms. 'Cause I know something the prince never knew. Oh, I dance with Cinderella. I don't wanna miss even one song. 'Cause all too soon the clock will strike midnight, and she'll be gone. She says he's a nice guy, and I'd be impressed. She wants to know if I approve of the dress. She says, Dad, the prom is just 1 week away, and I need to practice my dancing.
Gentlemen, a round of applause for the father of the bride.
For some other life.
Still together, still going strong. Still, still alive, true. Baby, take control.
Well, then this time, if you've attended St. Bonaventure, we'd like to invite all the St. Bonaventure crew out to the dance floor. We're going to do a photo shot with our group from St. Bonaventure. Thank you.
Can you bring it to the top?
Like a band on the top.
Can you bring it to the top?
Thank you. It's the cue, it's the heart, it's the masterpiece. It's too good to be true, it's better than you. My wildest dreams. Never keep, never tear you apart. Everything in this life is you crazy.
Mr. Nick James, as you are the toast for us this evening.
Hello, everybody. My name is Nick Jones, and I am Daryl Dixon's cousin. And I also have a little different perspective because Daryl is also my boss. So I'd like to take this time to ask for next week off pay. Good. No, I'm going to shout it. We've all ripped with Daryl a little bit this weekend. We've given him a hard time. He's been a great sport about it. But I want to take a moment to let everybody here know the type of person that I know Daryl Dixon as. And the type of person that Kayla is so lucky to have join part of her life. Daryl has one of the absolute biggest hearts of anybody I've ever met. And if you ask anybody in our family that's here tonight, they will back me up. Daryl. Daryl would do anything for anybody here. And I'm talking in this wedding party, over there, eating that he's never met, back in the dining room, working in the kitchen. Daryl would do anything for anybody here if he could. Thanks, Brandon. The reason Daryl has such a big heart is because Daryl is one of the most passionate people I've ever met. When Daryl does something, he puts his entire heart into it. It means the world to him, whatever it is. Whether it be playing in our cup matches, he's our emotional leader. Whether it be at work, during the day, at night, he'll just be thinking about things. He'll call me and he'll talk about it. Whether it be Kayla, he thinks we talk about her all the time at work, how much he's dedicating to her, how much he loves her. You look beautiful, by the way.
Thank you.
He puts his heart and his soul into everything. And that's why I know that his marriage with Kayla, and when they have kids, when they're together, he's going to put everything he has into that too. And I just want this family to know, our family knows this, and the family that he's joining, you've got a family member that will forever be there for you, will be passionate for you, put his heart and soul into everything he does for you. And I was just hoping that you guys would take a moment with me to raise a glass to Daryl and Kayla as they begin many years of happily married bliss together. To Daryl and Kayla.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Nick Jones. Be a lot of fun then. All right, so here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, as a tradition of incredible good luck, we're going to invite this gentleman to replace that garter onto her leg. So before we get started, just to talk a little bit about tradition. Tradition states that you must dance a little bit around her and you must slide that garter just a few inches above that ankle. And every inch above that ankle, well, that ankle's 1 year of good luck for our bride and groom. So let's try to get that all the way to the knee and get 100 years of good luck for our bride and groom, ladies and gentlemen. For that young lady and that gentleman, and let's have another round of applause for our bride and groom.
I'm gonna make you mine.
combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions of my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and how come we're so hard. It's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.